And hello there, guys. It's me, Mikachu. And what you see around you here is MunchyMC Prison. Very addictive. And this is going to be a really short video for all the new noobs coming in here, including myself, because I only played for 2 weeks. But I see that everyone that comes in here, they all have the same questions. And I just keep on answering them. And now I can refer to this video. So, anyway, let's get started. First of all, I want to say, I hope you like mining, because you're going to have to do a lot of that here in the prison. Here you will mine your wood. Well, you probably only do that here and there to decorate your cell a bit, because you will get a cell, of course. And here is a typical mine. And as you will see, this is the smallest mine in the spawn. And later, as you rank up, you can see to the right that I am rank C2. And that my next rank is actually in 7%, because I'm already 93%. And the rank up next to it, that is the amount that I have to reach to rank up. And as you rank up, you will get to better cells, better mines, and find more rare items. What it's very much about here, you have like semi-rare items, ultra-rare items, and legendaries. And you find those in crates and in chests. And while you're mining, you will find chests everywhere. So not so much in the beginning, but as you level up and you are like me, C2, I can say that I find chests pretty often. Very handy in the beginning is to use /help. You will see here info, commands, warps, rules, store, and vote. So if you click on info, you will get info about all kind of things. Here you have all the commands. So those are really handy commands, and we will look into all of those, how to use them. One exciting here is prison pass, because a prison pass actually takes you to the outside world, where you will fight a lot of zombies, but you can also find a lot of ultra rares. Here, /crate, and we will do that in a while, you have your daily crate, and depending on your rank, and you have like paid ranks, you can get more fancy crates. But just do /crate and you will see all the possibilities, what there is. Now, there are some very handy commands here, like for example, taking you to your cell. So here, home D50, just do that and bang. I'm in my cell within a second. There is no countdown. If you don't have a cell yet, a quick way to just actually get to all the cell blocks, so A, B, C, and D, is to just do /warp lobby, and it takes you to the cross point of the four, and then you can just choose the one that is the right one for you at the moment. So if you're a beginner, that would be D. And as you can see, very lovely decorated. I have done that myself. So that's nice in prison. You can build your own cell as you want. Outside the cell, not. But inside the cell, you are the boss. Only thing, you can't change the floor. You can only do that if you have a paid rank from the website. Anyway, as you guys can see, a lot of furnaces here. And that's because, basically, when you mine and you find stuff, you can sell it right away. Just going to show that, sell, and you do like that, and you can sell by right clicking anything here. Let's say I had a lot of gold here and I right click gold, I sell everything, and I can also just sell all my 64 stacks by left clicking. So, what about before you have the sale then? Because your first sale, and that is your cheapest sale, is. What? Did you see that, guys? Huh? I suddenly had a riot shield. Well, anyway, it says here Mikachu 3500, so that is the rent, and it's mine. But be very, very careful. If I do this now, it says in the chat, you still have whatever how many minutes to pay the rent. But even when you do have a sale, it expires in 7 days. So really make sure to pay your rent before that somebody else can rent the sale and take your stuff. And you pay the rent by clicking twice on the sign. And if you are cellmate with someone, you can even pay their rent. So that means they don't have to go online. And how lovely, I suddenly have a crate. Yeah, I didn't really figure that one out, but suddenly there are just crates in my inventory. So that's nice. And I am, of course, also going to have my daily crate, which everyone will have that comes in. And I'm going to tell, very important, when you come in the beginning, you get the beginner's crate. Well, what should you do with that? Do not open that in an unsafe place because you don't have a cell. But what you can do right away is, so you can open it and then you do this storage. Bang. And you get your storage container. Keep all your goodies there. What with this riot shield? Okay. Anyway, you need, of course, a pick to mine. So how do you do that before you have a cell? Well, let's go back to spawn. So here in spawn there is, and it's here. Okay. There. It is a crafting table. So this is your sort of like desperate crafting table before you have any safe place. Because only in your own cell can you build and put down things. So, how do you get that money together? Well, just go mining like crazy. And I think we all have our own tactics, and mine is very boring. It's just going straight down. I just show that here once. Because basically, then I can drink my coffee with my other hand. And it has turned out, I've tried a lot of ways of mining, but this really just always works. So I just mine all the way down here. Every now and then I fall into somebody's hole, but I never died. And one time I fell into my own hole. Then I definitely died. So you can grab all the things you see around you here. The most interesting are, of course, diamonds and emeralds, that you really get a lot more money for those when you're selling than for the rest of the stuff. Gold is also good. And so you probably wonder why I just mine straight down without stopping. Well, it's because I really do need to find chests. So they. For me, that's more important than any diamonds and emeralds. And because this has turned out to be the best way to find me the most chests, to just ignore items around and just drill straight down. And of course, in this noob mine, which is only in the beginning, I say, not gonna find anything. So I'm gonna take you, and when you want to go to any other mine, you just go warp. So my own mine is my rank and then mine. So if I was a lower one, I can go to all the lower ones. Like I like to go and check this one, for example, because we will go there now. Sometimes if nobody is here and you're lucky, there can be chests above the surface. Well, not this time, and we will just go to my mine. Oh, C2. And if you're lucky, you are kind of alone in your mine, which of course gives you more chance to find things. And as you can see, if we compare this to the first mine, you will see that this is the C2 mine and that there are a lot more goodies here. So how higher you get, your chance is much bigger to find good stuff. And let's eat a bit. So, what about food? Since we're anyway talking about eating. Well, warp, food, bang, takes you. And I mean, we are just here. You can see the brute lounge there. We are just in the lobby. And here is Mrs. Lunch Lady. So, hello. There we go. Okay, let's just grab some steaks. Always make sure to have some extra in the house. And since we're anyway here, we have been talking about cells, but there are also tables. So you can sort of create your gang around the table, you can invite people to your table. And what is the nice with the table is here your food bar is always full. So just hang here if you're going to do some PvPing. Which doesn't happen often in the prison that there is PvPing, but every now and then there is an event where actually then you're not safe anywhere in the prison. And so then you can go and hide in your cell, and the truth is that you're sometimes for some events not even safe there. And otherwise you just go PvPing, but realize that you won't stand that much of a chance in the beginning, because those are very good guys PvPing, and they have most likely much better gear than you. So even if you think yourself that you are good at PvPing, since you don't have maybe the good gear yet, you still won't stand much of a chance. And let's take a look at this. So you saw we got here from the spawn, and it's a black market. So you can just click on one here, see what it is. Oh, somebody is selling the flesh mask. And then you can just buy it here. But next to that, you can also just, of course, put your own thing here that you want to put on the black market. So, for example, in the beginning, if you're not into collecting ultras, you could always sell your stuff here to get a lot of money because some of them are really going for millions. Let's just take a quick look again at my storage. See here, like I have some really ultra rares. Whoops, that is quick. You have to be very quick when you open your storage. And just want to say that if you don't pay for anything with real money here from the website, you are stuck with one storage container. But you can buy more container space there, and that might be handy because that's not that expensive. So let's just say now that you have been mining enough, and let's take a look here. You guys see auction? So somebody is auctioning something. So you have the black market and you have auctions. So I'm just going to show that. So let's say, for example, I want to sell my enchanted sword here. I hold the sword in my hand. I do auction. And then I say, what is my start bidding price? I have no idea, so let's just do something 10,000, and then how much I want people to increment, so go higher every time. So I don't want any crap bids from $1, so I will say 1,000. That's it. Then I'm starting my auction, and then people will bid. And of course, when you are bidding, that's very easy because you just do bid and how much you want to bid. So nice black market or auction, whatever fits your needs. So let's anyway go back home where it is safe and cozy. And let's open this lovely crate that we got. So put it in your hand, put it down, and put it down again. And the nightmare here now is to get dirt. So let's hope we are not getting dirt. A prison pass. No. Oh, don't stop on the dirt. Don't stop on the. Oh my god. Look at that. We got another crate. Well, such fun. So let's open that one too. Yay! And there we go again. This is always such an exciting moment. Come on! Well, not bad. And why is that not bad? I tell you, because I'm 93 and I'm just going to use those right away. And maybe we will have the experience of leveling up. So, there, sell. And right click and sell them all in one. 98, look at that. I'm 98 now. And because I have all my chests here full with all kind of things, I probably can rank up now, so I will do that in a sec. And we have one more crate. And how is that crate? Oh, you saw that? Because I didn't cash in my daily crate. So, right click. And again. And there we go. Yet another crate. And bang. Ooh, an ultra rare, a little bit damaged, and it is Superman arms. So, what do we do with that, guys? We put it in the storage. Bang, and bang. So, saving my ultras. And I want to say something. We can go if you want to repair something. You have to warp to the loo. There we go. And here in the loo, we have sinks. Just right click and put your stuff in here and it will be repaired for a certain price, of course, what you will be asked. So that will be depending on, of course, how rare something is. And here is Santa. This is the drug dealer. Of course. Here, look at that. All kind of drugs. So be careful, because every now and then there is a drug control from the prison guards. Anyway, so you know, drug dealer in the loo, in the toilet, and your possibility to repair. And if you have a paid rank, then you can do slash repair. But we don't have that at this moment, so we're stuck with the loot. So what about if you do want a PvP? No, when you go outside with a prison pass, you can always PvP. But you can also PvP inside here in PvP zones. So just follow those signs. And this was, of course, also the way to the black market. And no, here. Look at that. If I enter now over that red zone and there is somebody here, we can PvP together. And they might even be sneaking around the corner here. Anyway, if you are not so much of a PvPer or you think I do it when I go outside, you are most of the time safe in here. Only sometimes there are events and that will be shown with the red text in the chat and then you better run and hide in your cell. And when you go outside, everything is PvP. And not only PvP, there are so many zombies outside and they are just really strong and really fast. So that is one of the more exciting things to go outside. And of course, to go outside, you need a prison pass. So make sure to not lose the prison pass that you find. Because, yeah, they're pretty rare. I actually managed to get killed when I had my first three prison passes, and yeah, that was kind of sad. So, what about gang? Well, look at that gang. So, gang info. No, I just do gang create me, whatever your name want to be, and you need to be at least rank savage. So, rank savage is a paid for with real money rank, and otherwise, then just forget a gang because you are obviously not allowed to create one, but you can still join one. But what you can do is friend, and friend is very nice. Here, you can not only add, so you can do add, and then you do the friend's name, and you can do promote once they are your friend, so you can promote to trusted and you can promote to cellmates. First they go to trusted and then they go to cellmate, so you don't have to say anything after, just their name. So that's how you do that. So friends, very handy. And I should say that a cellmate, that's the best level. That's if you're really good friends, because then they can actually not only look in your chests, but they can also take things from your chests. And otherwise, if you only promote them to trusted, they can look in your chests, but they cannot take anything from your chests. Well, if you don't really trust somebody and you want to show off all your lovely stuff, you can do then promote to trusted. So, what about what you see here? Brute lounge, brute lounge. So let's go here and run in there. And oh, we can run all the way here. And then, bang, you need to be a brute to enter this area. Oh, I so want to know what's in here. Anyway, that's also a paid rank. So you have paid ranks for thug. For savage and brute is the most expensive, and only then are you allowed into the brute lounge. I should say a very important thing, and that is scamming is allowed. So be very careful with that. You are not allowed to nag about it because everybody knows it. So if you get screwed, just don't do business with that person again. And somebody that scams the whole time will, of course, not be very popular. And I just want to show, let's go to at home C50. I lived in D50 and I just bought C50. So you will see here that if you remember the other cell, this is a lot bigger because this, you hear that sound? That's the sound that somebody has found an ultra rare. So this is what you see here, all in wood. This is all the C block. Much more fancy. And of course, I can't get into the B block, so I don't know what it looks like there. And then you go to when you get higher and higher in rank. But I have to say that already now the C2 rank, that now to go to C3 is quite a bit of work, because it gets more and more expensive every time. So like to say D4 is really quite easy to get to, and yeah, it gets harder and harder, like the price kind of more than doubles every time. Before we say goodbye, I just want to show one more thing, because this is really the way that you easy rank up. I should also say, first of all, that to rank up you do so slash rank up, and then you have to do rank up confirm. Forgot to say that. Anyway, every now and then, I told you there are those events. So it can be an event like a rainbow rush, a gold rush. And actually, those are events, they are bought by people on the online store, and I have bought five of those events just to be able to show it. It's $10, so if you have $10 and you want to rank up quick, this is a good way. So you see the rank, that is just this one here, what I hold in my hand now, that is the event pass. So I'm just going to click that now and bear with me because this is the first time. All right, look at that. So I can choose. So Diamond Rush, Gold Rush, Rainbow Rush, the drill event. I didn't even know about those events. And a chest refill. Okay, refills the chest outside the prison. That's a good one. Anyway, because I bought five of them, let's just do all three and you guys can see the difference. So, Rainbow Rush, go! So, just hang around here, grab your pickaxe, just gonna be here already. And there we go! Oh, don't lag, don't lag, don't lag. Just go down, down, down. Anyway, this is the way I do it. I just drill down like crazy, and you probably should try to get the best things around here. And it happens here also sometimes that you fall into a hole. So, well. And once I fell into a hole where I think a lot of people died, because suddenly when I came back to my cell, I had 700 emerald. And there we go. Look, there's the hole that I did. Oh. That was it. Yeah. Didn't do very well there. Can't talk and concentrate. Anyway, let's grab two more then. I just didn't want to take all of them out of here in case I die. Ready for the next one. So, and we are gonna do the diamond rush. Yeah, let's go, go, go. Everyone is very happy when there is a rush. And crap, 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 crap. Oh, it's a little bit laggy. That's kind of sad. Sometimes it's very laggy when you do this. So as you can understand, you really get a lot with this compared to normal mining. Well, I'm not doing very well here. Yep, give me that look. Give me that look. Okay, boring. And let's do that, the last one. Storage. And so. And there we go. And let's do the gold rush. Yep. Hey. And I'd say just drill down here and see all these people below me. There you heard somebody, I think, fall in a hole. But I don't have a miner's pick, and I think if you have a miner's pick, you will drill down a lot faster and grab a lot more. So I think also before we stop, we're of course now gonna run to our cell after this. Okay, looking good. Oh, did I get all those? Okay, let's go to the cell. There we go. That was fun. Okay, so of course now we are gonna rank up. So would be nice to. I'm just gonna do all of them right away. So. And those. There we go. And let's just sell all our crappity crap. And there we go. And there we go. And oh, forgot that one, but it doesn't even matter. So, And what do we have? Look at that. 102%. That means we have reached our rank. So just gonna do that. Rank up. Yes, and then rank up again. There we go. So there we go. We are C3. So just let's just take a look at the C3 mine before we leave each other. Warp shot. And there we go. Always exciting to come to a new mine. Come on, give me a chest. Boring, 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 boring. Okay, well, you can also go down here all the way and may seem useless, but I've actually a couple of times I have found chests while doing this, but I can see already here from a distance that it's not going to turn up any chests here. So that was dead boring. There we go. Well, if you want to stop from the bottom, you can always do that here. So let's go back to spawn. And so guys, that was it. Lot of mining. Oh, look at a drug raid. So you see that? If I would have gotten drugs now, I could be in trouble, but I haven't. So that's it, and I see you around here, I hope, 'cause this is, and trust me guys, this is just so addictive. I just love it. Okay, bye-bye.